The Indian state of Manipur has been going through a rough patch lately, with all the violence and unrest. To ensure security in the state, the central government has invoked Article 355 of the Indian Constitution. But what does that mean exactly? Well, Article 355 basically gives the central government the power to take necessary measures to protect a state from any internal or external threat. This is to make sure that the country's peace and security are not compromised. So in Manipur's case, the government decided to invoke this provision because things were getting out of hand. The clashes and protests between the two groups had created a law and order situation in the state that needed to be addressed immediately. Invoking Article 355 allows the central government to take appropriate steps to restore order and bring back peace. So why was this article invoked in Manipur? Because of the deteriorating law and order situation in the state. The clashes, blockades, and the protests between the two groups led to this crisis. Which are the two groups that were involved in the recent clashes? Kukis and Meiteis. The Meiteis are the largest ethnic group in the state, and they mainly live in the valley areas. Most Meiteis practice some form of Hinduism, and the Indian government recognizes them as other backward classes or OBCs. On the other hand, the Kukis are a tribal community that mainly live in the hill districts of Manipur. Most Kukis are Christians, and many of them converted during the colonial period when Christian missionaries arrived in the region. What led to the clash? The Meiteis felt like they were not getting enough power and representation in the state due to the hill tribes, while the Kukis felt like their land rights and political representation were being ignored by the government and the Meitei community. Things got worse when the High Court decided to give scheduled tribe status to the Meitei community, and protests broke out. These protests turned violent and people got hurt and even died. So the government had to step in and impose a curfew and deploy paramilitary forces. But wait, public order and police are state subjects, and states have the exclusive power to legislate on these matters. Then why did the center take the law and order of the state under its own hand? See, according to the Constitution, the responsibility for maintaining law and order and providing policing services falls primarily under the jurisdiction of state governments. This is outlined in the 7th schedule, which lists law and order as a state subject. So it is true that the state governments are responsible for ensuring public order and providing police services within their respective states. And it makes sense, because it will be administratively convenient and efficient if states manage the police. But sometimes, things can get out of control, like riots, internal conflicts, or violent situations like in the present case. If the state government is unable to handle the situation and protect the people, the center can step in and take over using Article 355. This ensures that the state is governed properly and in accordance with the Constitution. Part 18 of the Indian Constitution deals with emergency provisions. Look at Article 355. It says it is the duty of the Union, which means it is mandatory for the Union to protect states against external and internal threats. Therefore, this article authorizes the central government to intervene in matters related to public order and policing if there is a threat to national security or if the state government requests assistance. If the central government believes that the state police cannot tackle a threat to public order, it may even send armed forces to the state under the Armed Forces Special Powers Act 1958, also known as AFSPA. This authority to deploy armed forces is derived from Article 355. Another thing to note is that the Constitution does not mention how long the center's assistance should last when they intervene under Article 355. It is left to the discretion of the Union government to determine the type and length of aid necessary to restore normalcy. However, the courts have the power to review the duration of assistance given under the Article 355. If a person or the state government feels that the center has exceeded its powers or provided assistance for an unreasonable duration, they can approach the courts for redressal. The courts will assess the circumstances of the case and determine whether the center's actions were justified and whether the assistance provided was reasonable. Remember that the central government cannot interfere in the affairs of a state unless there is a constitutional breakdown in the state. As per the principle of federalism enshrined in the Constitution, Power is divided between the central government and the state governments, and each has its own sphere of authority. This was a quick video on Article 355 of the Indian Constitution. Thank you for your time.